Woodworkers will be all too familiar with the term kerf, which describes the width of the saw blade and how much wood it removes at the cut line. When you saw a piece of wood, you always need to compensate for the kerf to ensure that the wood is cut to the proper dimensions. On a laser, the kerf is the width of the laser beam, and it's typically a very small but fixed size, from 0.05 millimeters to 0.11 millimeter. Marquetarians likewise need to be aware of how much and where the laser's kerf affects the shape of the veneer. The basic idea is to position the cutter so that the pieces mesh perfectly one another when assembled, like a jigsaw puzzle. For example, in this image, the line drawn on an SVG file will determine the exact center between the two shapes. If you simply cut along those shapes, your shapes would come out too small by about half the width of the kerf. So the idea is you need to compensate for it and make the path glide just on the outside of that virtual cut line by about half the width of the kerf. Light burn gives you the opportunity to set it exactly, and the goal is to not make it so loose so that the pieces float around in there, or too tight so they don't fit, but make them just right. Not too loose, not too tight, but just right. This is the light burn application, an inexpensive program that will send your drawing to a laser cutter. You can use any kind of program. I like light burn. I think it works pretty well. So you click on the cut layers menu down here, and that sets this, and you get this menu to set on how you want the kerf to be, and it's really pretty straightforward. So if it's positive, it's going outward, so like 0.06 millimeters. Or if we did negative, it would go inward, so I'm gonna make that minus 0.06. And it's going inward. Meaning that the piece is going to actually get smaller. You can get the book, Painting with Light, A Guide to Laser Marquetry, available on Amazon. Thanks for listening.